Good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Hemambika from the Department of SNH from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I would like to discuss about the topic of infrared spectroscopy. So, the spectroscopy, any kind of spectroscopies, which are regarding with the term spectroscopy. To know this spectroscopy, we would like to know about the term electromagnetic radiation. What is called electromagnetic radiation? This is nothing but magnetic field as well as electrical field are applying perpendicular to each other in this direction and one direction. Those two are perpendicular to each other. Then the radiation is passing through which? Then it is named as electromagnetic radiation in a kind of medium. It is maybe a gaseous medium or any kind of medium can be used. So this is named as electromagnetic radiation, and from which a particle can travel into this can show one kind of theory that is named as wave theory. When a particle is exhibiting, generally there are two kinds of theories. One is particle theory as well as one is wave theory. Or particle nature, wave nature. Right. So in the wave nature or wave theory, a particle can show different kinds of parametric characteristics like wave number, frequency,
from here
are there, the wavelength is less, so it can be passed with more number of waves per unit time. And here the wavelength is greater, therefore how many number of waves per passing through per unit time, it is less. So these two are inversely related to each other. And next one, wavelength is inversely related to wave number, right? So in the same way, here with respect to time, here with respect to per unit time. So it is also inversely related to this wave number. Therefore, nu is proportional to nu bar. So nu bar is equal to C nu or C equal to like that. So we can suppose it, these two are directly related to each other. And from Planck's constant, so it is Planck's theory, E is equal to H. Okay, so here in this equation, we can observe that E equal to H, this is nothing but nu, is inversely related to this wavelength, so lambda is equal to C by A. So otherwise we can return in terms of this H C by A. So like that, each equation can be written in this way, like that it is H C nu bar. So like that we can able to understand these are the different kinds of relations made between the wave theory characteristics. Okay. So depending upon this, the electromagnetic radiation can be explained that when a light radiation is passing through the magnetic field as well as electrical field which are perpendicular to each other. Right. So here, according to wavelength as well as energy, there are so many kinds of radiations can be applicable. For example, here cosmic radiations and gamma radiations, UV radiations, visible radiations, IR radiations, microwave radiations, and radio wave radiations. So these are the different kinds of radiations in the electromagnetic radiations can be split according to its energy. For example, here we can able to understand that these are having greater energy compared to them. So here energy can be increased in this direction. So higher the energy consisting with cosmic radiations as well as lesser the energy consisting with radio waves. At the same time, inversely related to each other means E is inversely related to 1 by 2. Therefore here which is consisting of lesser wavelength, at the same time which is consisting of higher wavelength. Right. So out of which our topic is IR spectroscopy, here this IR radiations, when IR radiations is falling on a substance, for example this is a substance, when an IR radiation is falling on this, then automatically this is the incident radiation, some kind of radiation is absorbed by the substance and the remaining radiation will be transmitted from the substance. So there is a relation of the fundamental, that is I not equal to IA plus I2. Okay, so this is the same relation can be applicable to any kind of radiations or any kind of spectroscopies. So spectroscopy is nothing but when a radiation of electromagnetic waves which will fall on a substance, therefore some of the substance can be absorbed and the remaining substance will be transmitted out. Transmitted out means which is coming out from the substance. Right. So here, especially we are talking about the IR radiations, so we will discuss about the principle of IR radiation. First of all, we know, notice that there is some kind of energy or there is some kind of wavelength or wave number values will be there. So here IR radiations 0.8 microns to 200 micrometers. So this is the range of IR radiations. In this 0.8 microns to 2.5 microns, it is named as near IR, and 2.5 microns to 15 microns, it is named as mid IR, and 15 microns to 200 micrometers, it is named as far IR. Where the IR is situated, it is in between visible as well as microwave radiations. Okay, so therefore, here we can come to understand that this is the near IR and this is the far IR range, and this is a mid IR range. Now we able to understand that what is the application of main application of IR radiation. So this is applicable to identify the functional groups. For example, there are so many kinds of functional groups like amines, amides, hydroxy groups, so many kinds of groups are there. For example, NH2 group, amine group, and COOH, carboxylic group. like so many kinds of waves can be absorbed by using this. Where it is absorbed and what kind of frequency is required to absorb it. So this is the main goal of using this one. Where mid IR is there, then most of the functional groups can be identified by using IR spectroscopy. So this is named as main IR also. Right? Now this is a range. Next, coming to the part is, what is the main principle? When an IR radiation is falling on a substance, then which undergo vibration. So this is its principle. What is meant by vibration? Where there is a change in bond length, it is named as vibration. For suppose, if a substance is taking continuously change in its bond length, like deformations, which can undergo deformation. Vibration, it is nothing but deformation. What is called deformation means, it is nothing but elongations as well as compressions. Elongation and compression. So these two mixing, it is named as deformation, and which is nothing but called a vibration. So this is the main principle of IR spectroscopy. Okay, so when a substance, for example, here we can able to understand the moon. So what kind of substances undergo IR spectroscopy? There are two known points to understand that. One is heteronuclear molecules. Heteronuclear molecules undergo IR spectroscopy. And the second point is the molecules which are exhibiting its dipole moment. Dipole moment is not equal to zero. So these are the two conditions we can able to understand that these two conditions, those which molecules exhibit these two conditions undergo IR spectroscopy. So those are named as IR active molecules. IR active molecules. The remaining all the substances like heteronuclear, homonuclear molecules, at the same time dipole moment equal to zero molecules are named as IR inactive molecules. Okay, let us take an example of heteronuclear molecules. Let us take simple example of HCl. HCl, it is named as heteronuclear diatomic molecule. Why? Because two atoms are there. It is heteromolecule combined with two different atoms. So it is named as heteronuclear molecule. Right. Its dipole moment equal to not equal to zero. What is called dipole moment? Dipole moment is nothing but charge into distance. Charge into distance. So this molecule consisting of a positive charge H plus ions as well as negatively charged Cl ions. So which is consisting of a charge and these are separable by a internuclear distance. Okay. So when these two conditions are applicable, those molecules are IR active molecules. Right. So this is the note point. Now, let us have a look of taking the example of HCl. Then we can able to understand what is called a vibration. Okay, the main principle of IR is called vibration. Okay, so let us take an example of H plus ion as well as Cl minus ion. Okay, what is called vibration? A vibration, it is nothing but which can be vibrated. Can be vibrated or which can take elongations as well as compressions. That is nothing but vibration, means change in bond length. Okay, so if suppose a small internuclear distance, normal internuclear distance of a molecule, it is normal condition, okay, which is exhibiting plus charge and which is exhibiting minus charge, right? When suppose that there is a passage of IR radiation on this molecule, heteronuclear molecule, then there will be starting of elongation as well as compression. Right. Elongation, if suppose we want to elongate it, then automatically this is the elongation. This is elongation, means change in bond length, and bond length can be enhanced. Again, when we, for example, if you want to take a rubber band as an example, if you stretch it, it's elongation, it is called elongation. If you want to leave it, so it comes to its original position. So it is named as H. It is called normal position. If you want to compress the rubber band, so then its bond length will be reduced from like this. then it is named as one complete cycle of vibration. One complete cycle of vibration. Okay. So, for one complete cycle of vibration, how much higher radiation is required? That is named as its resonance. Okay. It is in terms of considered as one sine wave. One sine wave, it is nothing but one normal condition, one elongation, again normal, compression, again comes to normal condition. It is named as one complete cycle of vibration or one complete cycle. So it is represented with a sine wave curve.